Hey veg heads, we got sweet potato corn chowder cooking up right here on Veggieverse. You don't want to miss it. We got a delicious meal prepared for you today. We're gonna dice up a few vegetables here. We have a chopper, but you can use a knife, you can use a rake, whatever device you have in your house. Chop those veggies up. This just makes it easy and consistent, puts it all in a little holder, as you can see here. And then we just open up the bottom of the holder and everything dumps out into the pot. You want one white onion, 4 cloves of garlic, 4 celery ribs, 1 medium sweet potato, and 1 red pepper. And then you just dice it all up. This is coming out nice and neat, as you can see, just a couple hits and it pops out into the canister. Celery too, hard root vegetables like sweet potatoes, as you know, those are very tough. And comes out pretty easy even with those. Lime and habanero chili peanuts from President's Choice, delicious. They're a great snack, I have them every day. Lots of fat, so you gotta watch out for the hips. Sweet potato action, you gotta peel these suckers first. Obviously, you don't want your peelings in your soups. It's bad enough that the corn peeling's in there, and we'll get to that in a second. There's the garlic, minced up the garlic, put it all in the pot. You wanna throw a little splash of water there and let it just simmer, soften up for about 5 minutes. You get back to the sweet potatoes. We're still dicing those up. Here I'm showing off my mad chopping skills. One sweet potato dollar, one cover, one fist, one kill. Lots of tiny little potato cubes. As long as you cut them pretty thin, they come out all right. So now we got this, the vegetables. They've been on there for about 5 minutes. You can use oil, but we just decided not to, and I think it was a good decision. They came out all right. Excuse all the dishes, all the messy dishes. There's the vegetable broth coming in. 4 cups of water, 4 cups of the vegetable powder makes 4 cups of vegetable broth. Looks watery, but it comes out all nice. So we're just adding the water right now. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, I invite you to do so. Veggieverse on YouTube, posting a video on Tuesdays and Fridays, Tasty Tuesdays, Fitness Fridays. Like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell so you don't miss the videos, and share with your friends. I'm sure they'd love to see it. Is the K silent? Nors? Canors? That's one of those mysteries of life. Once we dump the cubed up potatoes in here, we're gonna stir it around, mix it all up, get the flavors all mixed in together. Once it comes to a simmer, we're gonna set the timer for 5 minutes. Recipe calls for 5 or 10, 5 worked for us. 4 cups of corn. And what she just added there was 2 teaspoons of chili and 1 teaspoon of paprika to give it that nice little zing. Mix it up, just let it cook. So after the timer stops and it's nice, the potatoes are nice and soft to a touch, scoop in about 2/3 of your soup into a blender and blend it. Nice puree, baby food. And then put it back into the soup pot. So now most of your corn is diced up. Here's where you can add your salt and pepper. Now, one thing about this is that a lot of people I've heard, and us included, don't really care for the diced up corn. It has that skin on it, and it's just kind of weird feeling. It's just kind of weird feeling, but it tastes amazing. You can only just imagine the words that are coming out of my mouth right now. This is so tasty. I could eat this for days and days, but yeah, I'm an idiot and didn't wait for it to cool down. So I get burned in my mouth, but it is really tasty. I recommend everybody trying this. So quick, so easy, so tasty, totally vegan, totally plant-based, and it made that huge pot, still eating it for days. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Try and make this chowder this week or something. The recipe is in the description below, and until next time, keep lifting, veg heads. And thanks for watching.